Welcome to the Health and Fitness Show with Tracy Markley.
You keep saying you got something for me.
Today's show is going to be about hydration. Hydrating your body, your brain, your ligaments, your fascia, your tendons, your tissue, your skin, your organs, everything. Your body needs water for every part of it to function the best that it can. Did you know that the brain is 80% water? The body is about 75% water and the bones are about 25% water. It's a lot of water it needs to function. If you end up at the hospital for dehydration, you're very ill. Your body's breaking down. But what some people don't realize is many of us walk around in our everyday life partly dehydrated. This can also play into pieces of cognitive skill loss, balance issues, more pain in the body, fatigue, depression, being more hungry. So what a lot of studies recommend is to take your body weight and cut it in half, and that's how many ounces of water you should have a day. So for example, a 200-pound man should have about 100 ounces of water a day. But keep in mind, if you have a kidney disease or if your doctor's watching your kidneys for some reason, let them tell you how much water you should have, because they may have a different amount that you need for your own personal health and kidneys. So remember that advice. Water flushes out toxins from waste from our organs. And do you know your brain is an organ? Your brain is a very complex organ, and your skin is the largest organ on your body. In a dehydrated brain, the very complex functions of the brain get disorganized, and it makes the body have many issues. It can slow down the brain's function of making neurons. And if you're someone who has a neuromedical condition, or you're a stroke survivor, and you're trying to build that brain back up, if you are slightly dehydrated, on top of the brain injury you're dealing with, you're going to have a double whammy, because now your brain's trying to repair from the brain damage when it's not being fueled with proper hydration for proper functioning. I also mentioned previously about the pain that you can have when you're dehydrated. Let me share a story with you. I work with a lot of stroke survivors and people with neuro challenges, and I've been doing this for about 20 years. And 2 years ago, I was asked to be on the Education Advisory Board for the MedFit Foundation, which is fabulous. They also asked me to write a CEC course on stroke recovery and exercise for the fitness industry. And so I did, and I've written 4 books and 2 are on stroke recovery. With both these situations, it put me in the public eye with some of the fitness professionals worldwide and stroke survivors. And I get questions and messages often asking me for advice. And one trainer back east, she has a stroke survivor, and every time she trained him, he got really bad pain through his legs, like cramping pain. And she wanted to know what I thought. My first question was, is he hydrating his body well enough? Because if you're dehydrated, you can get more pain and cramping. So she discussed this with him and got back to me about 4 weeks later and told me that was the best thing to hear, because he wasn't drinking enough water. And it took about almost 3 weeks of him drinking it daily for his body to start working with the system and staying hydrated, and then he doesn't get the pain anymore. So I thought that was fabulous. So when you're trying to get yourself to become hydrated after having the poor habits of not hydration of the water, it can take 2 weeks to a month or so for your body to get used to it, because your body's not used to you drinking it. So it has this habit of not holding on to it, or you go to the restroom more, and it needs to become in a balance. Just like if you take a hormone medicine or a thyroid medicine or a medicine that you have to take 2 or 3 months for your body system to come in balance with it, that's how hydration is too. So if you have the habit, like most of us do, drink real good water for a day or two, and then you don't, and then you do, and then you don't. It slows down your metabolism, first of all, and it throws the fluids in your body out of balance. So if you're trying to get your body to become properly and healthy with hydration for your brain and your organs, your ligaments and fascia, for all the things I've shared, you have to take the time to do it. You may have to put up with running the restroom several times the first week or two. Your body has to become in the habit finding the balance to hold on to it again. You will find the balance, and you will find possibly you may sleep better, you start losing weight more, you have less pains, maybe less headaches, and some of these little quirky elements that we get that the doctors can't really find a diagnosis for, but you know they just don't feel right for you, try the hydration. Remember, there's cucumbers, watermelon, celery, there's foods and vegetables and other ways to get the hydration. So check that out. Take care of your body. Stay hydrated. Give yourself the next few weeks or a month and see what kind of changes you have in your body. And have a healthy day.
You've been listening to the Health and Fitness Show with Tracy. Go have a great day, fit day, and a healthy day.
Are you ready, Boots? Start walking.